Welcome to Any Way You Slice It, where we talk about your identity and purpose in the kingdom of God. Come join author Ricardo Richardson as we slice our way to the core of God's Word to experience the beautiful and transformational discovery of who we are and why we exist, no matter how we slice it.
Today's message is Apologetics. Beloved family, our text says, "Then Agrippa said to Paul, 'You have permission to speak for yourself.' So Paul motioned with his hand and began his defense. 'King Agrippa, I consider myself fortunate to stand before you today as I make my defense against all the accusations of the Jews, and especially so because you are well acquainted with all the Jewish customs and controversies. Therefore, I beg you to listen to me patiently.' Acts 26:1-3. There was a professor of apologetics who, when talking to another person about his profession, was encouraged by them. They said, 'That's great that you teach people that, because we need more people to learn how to apologize.' Although today the word apologize has a different meaning from apologetics, they both traditionally stemmed from the Greek word apologia, which means to defend. But it's interesting, somehow the world almost always introduced religion. Apologizing is now meant to ask someone for forgiveness, as in, I'm sorry. The world system has changed the word apology from its original meaning from defense to asking for forgiveness. And religion has adopted the legal word apologetics from law to religion. No wonder we're so confused. We have to apologize for apologetics, no pun intended. In the Greek legal system, the prosecution delivered the accusation or charge, and the defendant replied with a defense. The apologia was a formal speech or explanation to reply to and rebut the charges. In today's court system, we use the terms charges and defense. The prosecution accuses, and the defendant defends. Today, we hear apologetics used more in religion than in law. But it is the same Greek word apologia that Socrates and Paul used as a defense to their legal charges. Socrates' apology was his public defense at his trial for numerous charges. Socrates stepped forward, addressed each of their charges, and explained why he was innocent, or in some cases, why he was guilty, but why what he was guilty of was a good thing. This is the same defense Paul is making in our opening text today. He is on trial for accusations against his faith. Paul is on trial for being accused of his faith to Festus and Agrippa when he says, "I make my defense," in Acts 26:2. And Paul states this in his letter to the Philippians in 1:7 as he is defending the gospel. And Peter says, "But in your hearts, revere Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. But do this with gentleness and respect." 1 Peter 3:15. In his defense, Paul simply laid out what he believed and why. And the king asked Paul, "Do you think that in such a short time you can persuade me to be a Christian?" Paul replied, "Short time or long, I pray to God that not only you, but all who are listening to me today may become what I am, except for these chains." As kingdom citizens, we simply tell people about our country. No one defends why they were born in their country or where they are from. Yet, religion has made us think we have to defend our faith. Paul and Peter is admonishing us to know our constitution, the Bible, and to know our rights as citizens in the kingdom. We don't have to tear down anyone else's belief or try to persuade them. Just have the mindset of Paul and say, "No matter how long it takes, I pray that everyone may come to the knowledge of Jesus Christ." No apologetics, no apologies. I defend my faith by my faith. Much love.